Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Obviously today is Friday and we are still in the month of January while I was doing my daily DIYs. However, today it's going to be my last ever paper squishy. Like, my last ever one forever, I think. I'm really sorry to everyone who really likes them. I'm just not vibing with them much and I don't want to be making content that I don't really like. So I figured this is going to be my last one. This was a request from a few people, so thank you so much for your request. I will obviously put your comment on screen now. So hopefully you enjoy this very last paper squishy video of mine. I do have a huge playlist of loads you can go back and watch. I will create it and pop it into my description down below if you want to carry on watching those type of videos, but there will not be any more paper squishies going forward on my channel. Like I said, I'm really sorry about that. If you like them, I'm just not vibing with them much, and obviously I don't want to do them if I don't want to do them, so there's that. But this is how my dairy milk paper squishy turned out today. I have got a little face on it. Look at that face, it's adorable. I was watching Riverdale as I was doing this and I thoroughly enjoy that program, so that's what got me through this one. So yeah, hopefully you enjoyed today's video, and I'm just gonna get straight on into it. So obviously with a paper squishy, you're going to need your paper. The paper that I use is just regular printer paper, just literally A4 paper, which I use for my printer. Like, I buy it in like those reams which have like 300 sheets in or something, just for my printer anyway. So that's the paper that I use. A lot of people ask me about this, but that's what I've always used and it's been absolutely fine. The pens that I've been using in my recent videos, these ones here, are the Arteezer Twee markers. Really love them. They were gifted to me a long time ago, but I've loved them so much that I've actually got another set since, and I really like them. I have so many of these pens now, it's crazy. But these pens actually have a fine liner on one side and then like a brush nib on the other. I really like a brush nib on a felt tip anyway, and I really like a fine liner. The fact that they got a 2-in-1 on every single color is absolutely amazing, because you're able to do this, like draw out the logo with the fine liner, then obviously fill in the rest with the brush tip, which I think works so well for paper squishies and obviously lots of other things. But yeah, I really love the combination of that and would highly recommend them. I used to use the Crayola like super tips or something, and I recently found them. They color really nicely, but I obviously don't have the fine liner. I've also used ones from Amazon before, the Magic Fly brand ones, and they worked really nicely, but the brush nib wasn't as nice as these ones. So I'll leave a link down in the description, probably will be affiliated, but these, like, I'm not paid to talk about them or anything like that. Like, I just really like them, and then if you buy through that link, then I sometimes get a tiny commission of what you purchase. Like, yeah. That's how affiliate links work. But anyway, when I made this squishy today, I just drew out the logo. I actually usually just sketch it out roughly with a pencil. I didn't do that in this one. I just kind of drew it out so I had the space in there, and then just went for it with the fine liner, which is probably why my dairy milk logo isn't as neat as I would usually like it. But like I said, I'm just not feeling the paper squishies and I had no passion to be making this today, and I don't like to create content when I don't have passion for it, so that's why this is going to be my last one. I am very sorry to anyone who obviously likes them. I do feel really bad, but yeah, I'm sure there's plenty of other creators that still make them, and like I said, I do have a playlist of like 75 different designs that you can go back and watch if you still want to watch them. So I drew in and around the Cadbury logo, just going in there. I did do it in my own kind of design, kind of added more swirls and stuff in it just to make it a bit more fancy. Don't know why, I just felt like doing that. And then I thought I'd add a bit of extra colour in it by putting the £1 logo on, which you can sometimes find on bars, which I think is really cool. It's just that yellow colour. I really like the contrast between the yellow and the purple there, so I drew that out on another piece of paper and then stuck that down so it's really bright, because obviously it was an afterthought. To add the face on, I just used a Sharpie pen on top of a piece of clear tape, and then I went in with some acrylic paint just to add some extra details in, like painting the inside of the mouth pink, and then added some teeth on. I don't know why I decided to put teeth on this one, but I really like it. I think it's so funny. Then I went back in and tried to neaten up the Dairy Milk logo a little bit with the white acrylic. Didn't do that much of a great job, but it did kind of thicken out that Y there, which was the main bit that was bugging me. For the mouth, I did go back in once the acrylic paint had dried and drew over the, like, the black outline of it, because I did go over it with the acrylic paint a little bit, so I wanted to neaten that up as well. So once that was all done, all the painting, all the drawing, everything was completely done, completely dry, completely complete, I then covered the whole thing in clear tape, taping up the ends and taping up the long side. Now, did I say that I cut this down? I cut it down so it was a little more narrow, like a dairy milk bar would be, and then I just stuffed the kind of paper bag bit up and then sealed it down with clear tape. You always use the same stuffing, just a mixture of toy stuffing as well as memory foam scraps. So once that was done, my squishy was then complete. I now fancy dairy milk Cadbury bar, but what can you do? I just love it. So now that it's all taped up, all sealed up, all the stuffing and stuff is all inside, this is how the paper squishy has turned out. Obviously, I've stuffed it with memory foam and I've stuffed it with toy stuffing the same way that I always do, simply because I always have like memory foam scraps left around from making memory foam squishies. Besides that, really happy with the colours on it. I don't really like my logo. I feel like I did a rubbish job at this, and I feel like I should have done the face a bit bigger because it's just like there. But besides that, I think it's kind of cute. I like the swirly twirly version of the Cadbury's logo that I did there, because obviously it doesn't look like that in real life, but I thought it looked kind of cute with all those little swirls on. So squishiness wise, this is what it's like. Not great, but not too bad. I've had worse and I've certainly had a lot better. But hopefully this gives you one last idea for the paper squishies. Thank you so much for obviously following me along my paper squishy journey. I was originally making these like a couple years ago now, and now they just don't really kind of suit what I want to do going forward on YouTube, which is why I'm going to be, you know, stopping them now. I do feel really bad for you guys who always request them, but I did want to put this in a video that I'm not going to be doing anymore, just because I tried doing them again and yeah, not really vibing. It's not really my thing anymore. But yeah, sorry about that. I hope you have a lovely day, and I will see you tomorrow for another DIY. So sorry. Bye.